Highway Point family, today is a great day. It's been gorgeous. It's beautiful outside right now, and I'm sitting out here, as you can see, at our church property on the grass. And with kind of this environment in mind, as you have likely already heard, we are now legally permitted to hold services outside with up to 100 people in attendance. So I'm so grateful for the opportunity for the church to start physically gathering and meeting together once again. As we gather together, I am mindful of the variety of feelings and emotions people are feeling regarding Governor Inslee's orders, the virus itself, and what we should be doing in response to those things. I hear you, I hear the frustration, I hear kind of what's going on, and I'm here for you. Elders and deacons are meeting later on Sunday to pray and discuss those particular issues, kind of responses to Inslee and all of those kinds of things. Right now, I'd like to speak to you as one of your pastors from the basis of Romans 14, the idea of sanctuary, and John 13, 34 and 35. So Romans 14, 7 through 13 says this: "For none of us lives for ourselves alone, and none of us dies for ourselves alone. If we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So, whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord. For this very reason, Christ died and returned to life so that he might be the Lord of both the dead and the living. You then, why do you judge your brother or sister? Why do you treat them with contempt? For we all will stand before God's judgment seat. It is written, 'As surely as I live, says the Lord, every knee will bow before me, every tongue will acknowledge God.' So then, each of us will give an account of ourselves to God. Therefore, let us stop passing judgment on one another. Instead, make up your mind not to put any stumbling block or obstacle in the way of a brother or sister." I find this passage convicting, especially verse 13. You know, that passage was written to the Roman church, that same Roman church that we've been studying together on Sundays. And they were dealing with different things than what we are right now. But I believe that that concept of not putting a stumbling block or an obstacle in the way of a brother or sister is applicable to us today. And it's part of what we're called to be and how we're supposed to act towards one another as a church. It challenges me to be willing to lay down personal freedoms in order to help others in their followership of Jesus. It makes me think about providing a sanctuary, which is a place of refuge or safety. In our world right now, there is all kinds of tension, divisiveness, and angst. We all see it, we all feel it, it's everywhere. In response, I would like to offer you refuge and safety, and I would like to invite you to join me in offering that same sanctuary to those who probably need it most. I'm thinking of the person who is not sure, but thinking about coming to a service and is immune compromised. To the person who would like to come, but is experiencing a moral and ethical conflict because they desire to follow the governor's order and guidelines. To the person who might be new to Waypoint and wants to try church for the first time. So creating a sanctuary that is a refuge and a safe space right now requires us to take certain steps that we might find uncomfortable. So with all of that in mind, this Sunday, we are asking you to, number one, monitor your own health before coming. This is honor system. We trust you, we believe you, but be mindful. Second is BYOE, not BYOB, that's something else. BYOE, which is bring your own everything. And so chairs, Bible, lyrics, notepads, whatever it is that you might want to have access to while you're here for the service, please bring that. It makes our job so much easier, and I think it'll be kind of cool. We'll get to be out here in the grass. Hopefully it doesn't rain, and it's just going to be a lot of fun. So when we're done, the opposite is true. So it's TYOE, which is take your own everything. Please just be mindful and make sure that you've been a good Boy Scout and left no trace behind. I think that's a thing. Number three, maintain 6 feet of distancing. Four, sit with your family including children. 5, refrain from direct contact. Yes, this includes hugs and handshakes. I know this is gonna be hard, I get it, but in this space, in providing sanctuary, this is what we are asking one another to do, just for all who are present. 6, wear your mask for the duration of the service. This is gonna be another tough one. Again, I get it. Singing with a mask on is probably not going to be comfortable. We're still gonna sing. It's probably gonna be like what we've had for our recent online services and our drive-in service, which is a little bit shorter. And we wanna sing together, but we need to abide by this. And then finally here, 7 is prayerfully consider your own conscience and willingness to follow these guidelines. No judgment here, but I really am asking you to prayerfully consider this. If the thought of wearing a mask through the service or having to refrain from direct contact or having to sit with your family, although I'm sure that you love your family, if those things, you just feel like you can't follow them because you don't trust yourself or because of your own conscience in that regard, then we would ask you to prayerfully consider that and think about attending our online service, which is bringing me to this Sunday. We will provide an online service at 10 a.m. for those who feel it is best for them to stay home. Again, no judgment here. If you just feel like it's safest, it's best for you to stay home, or that's just the choice that you need to make, then please go ahead and do that and join us online. It'll be great. Second, Waypoint North services will be at 9 and 10:45. We're gonna go with 2. And then Waypoint South service will be at 10:45 at Tim and Karen Cedarlands. 3, at Waypoint North, we will continue to broadcast the service to 88.3 FM for those who wish to stay in their cars. Again, it might be raining, we don't know. It's looking kind of hopeful, but we're not sure. At Waypoint South, we're just gonna go ahead and use a small sound system, just kind of feedback from that event. Seems like that might just be a better choice for that environment. 4, we will provide hand sanitizer in several locations and of course soap and water in the bathrooms. 5, we will provide masks for those who don't have one. 6, we will sanitize restrooms and other high touch services, although we believe that'll be minimal with an outside service. Finally, I would like to encourage you and challenge you with John 13 verses 34 and 35. A new command I give you, love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. We may have varying opinions and feelings, but even in this season, or perhaps especially in this season, let's pursue love and unity in Christ. I love you guys so much. I can't wait to worship with you. God bless you. Have a great day.